old ass PS2 shit. To dicks.
To dick.
Media
active. Media active.
To dicks.
It's active media.
To dicks.
Is this the ripoff of the 20th Century Fox logo?
Yeah. Wow.
It's even got the little, like, Civil War pipes.
Yeah. Wow.
Why are there so many fucking producers for this fucking game?
This game better be amazing.
This is the third goddamn producer. This is a PS2 game. That's fucking unheard of.
I don't think so. Well, I think it's just, that...
It wouldn't have happened as much for a PS2 game as anything else. Oh, should this Robotech?
Yeah, it is.
Fuck yeah.
Neat.
I haven't played this before, actually.
It's really good.
Awesome.
I remember it being good. If you like high-speed robot action! Because you can, like, swap between plane and the robot.
Oh, cool.
And Robotech is like a really famous anime.
Okay.
It's like on like par with like Gundam shit. Like it's huge.
Okay. So I should have waited for anime month then.
It's fine. Yeah. I don't know shit about Robotech other than how popular it is.
Yeah. Well, that's all right.
Shit.
I like
robots.
The way the fucking like weird thing runs. Boom, it's boom, just like blit 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 blit. Flopping his whole torso around every time it takes a step.
Hell yeah. You gotta flop your torso around before you take a stoop.
I got a real floppy torso.
Hey, baby, I got a floppy torso. You wanna flippity-floppity it?
Video mode, fuck. Can I set it to PAL? That'd be crazy. I don't know how to play.
I guess you might want new training. I don't know how long training is for this game.
Fuck it.
Yeah. Just get thrown in. Booby trap.
Booby
yeah.
trap.
I'll just do it wrong trap. And I'll ask for forgiveness instead of asking for permission.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's the head. What are all those heads?
That's so good.
Yeah.
Creepy. Fucking weird drawn Link just pointing at some shit off screen and going, what are all those heads? That's the weirdest thing you could have said.
This one dies less, dies more, but is like better at everything.
Yeah.
Well, his armor looked pretty good.
Trainer, generic, Jack, trainer, generic. We'll go Jack. Because that's the most detailed one.
That's the one that like has a design.
Yeah, it looks like Starscream, so I'm all aboard.
My name is Jack Archer,
and
I'm a pilot of the Robotech Defense Force. I was born just before the Global War. My parents died soon after the war began, so I had to learn how to survive on my own. Sometimes I wonder what kind of person I might have been if things were different. It's one of my darkest fears. If you took the war out of me, would there be anything left? The global war had been going on for a long time. All the experienced pilots were dead. My government was desperate.
All the experienced pilots were dead.
The draftees started getting younger and younger. I needed a way to escape all that misery on the ground.
I needed to draft so dodge I didn't like mind crazy.
Much when yeah, I,
yeah. I got crossed eyes. I got.
It was like
my
I was
feet are too flat.
I grow hair inside my eyeballs. It's a very itchy problem.
Yeah.
After a few years, the government dissolved. I became a mercenary, hiring out to any nation that could afford me. I didn't care. Just so long as I stayed up.
Just so long as I didn't have to kill anybody with war. Oh, wait.
Yeah, wait. Oh, shit.
The war ended in a single day. All it took was a miracle. A gigantic alien spaceship broke through hyperspace on a collision course with the Earth and crashed into a small island in the South Pacific called Macross Island.
Oh, right, Macross is part of the Robotech series. I forgot, it's a whole thing.
Whole
thing with that.
Got it.
All
now,
this exposition.
Now I understand what you're talking about.
All this exposition shit Robotech has a very long history.
Yes.
There's a lot of shit he is just glossing over. Beyond what we had on Earth. I realize that now. I'm like, oh yeah, that is all a thing. Robotechnology.
Okay.
But there was an even greater discovery. The scientists found a supply of protoculture aboard the ship.
Because I knew all those things were like in universe, but I didn't have a name for it. Now that I know it's all Robotech
universe, and Macross, kind of and all that shit's all the same stuff.
Yeah, Macross and Micross, and
they called the Micross universe. Super Dimension Fortress, or the
SDF-1 for short. Shut the fuck
They
up.
Began rebuilding the ship as they unlocked the secrets of Robotechnology.
Shut secrets the of fuck up.
After the arrival of the SDF-1, work kind of dried up for a while. With the war over, no
was one able
to
creep on club girls. Though.
Yeah, yeah.
Finally, I can creep on.
Look at it! Look at his fucking hands.
Yeah, he's like, I'm gonna get
he's
you.
He's doing a weird, like, I'm gonna pinch you thing.
Yeah. Those were happy
times. I'm gonna get you with my grabbers.
Macross City. My grab.
Helping to rebuild the SDF-1. I was just getting used to my new
life.
Don't
wear a tank top while you're welding. Legendary
skull leader himself recognized me as I don't know why he's doing that.
Yeah.
We admit a few times. He probably wear fucking like sometimes burn-proof skirt or apron, and then like clothes that are flame retardant.
Over the years, we ended up forming.
While you're upside down using a welder.
He told me he needed pilots to join a new military outfit called the Robotech Defense Force. Roy said they had some new kind of high-performance fighter that could beat anything I ever flew. They called it a Veritech. I made Roy prove it to me, fighter to fighter.
I killed
him. Yeah?
Yeah?
Why did the military need a transforming fighter? It was well
know,
known that the aliens were warriors, but there was one detail that was kept from the public. In a top secret debriefing,
I feel like they're like spoiling like decades of like content.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. 40-foot tall giants. The RDF developed the Veritech fighter to fight the aliens on their own terms. It would mean the difference between survival and extinction.
And not survival.
After my training, I was stationed with the carrier Prometheus on Macross Island. On the day the final construction of the SDF-1 was completed, the entire city prepared to celebrate.
God that damn. Was when the like, just let me play the story mode. I had story mode, I didn't know it was going to be just, we tell you the story.
Yes, the story mode is where they tell you the story. Training
oh,
is actually, because you can't fight in the war, you have to train to be in the war. You're just running
here
like,
we
drills
go.
And stuff.
Chapter 1, booby trap on the day the people of my head. Yep, all that stuff you just said. Right there. Help Wolf and Skull Squadrons turn back the alien threat. So it's probably going to be like I think this game might play like a Rogue Squadron type deal where you just do your thing and you just try to kill off everybody. And
okay.
Like,
I have not played that before.
You never played Rogue Squadron?
I don't believe so, no.
Oh, shit. That's like one of the best like flight games ever. Still like holds up.
Nice.
It's a Star Wars game.
So that should be a fun first for me then.
Yeah.
This is gonna be a disaster. I'll hand it off soon. Okay.
Oh sweet. You got like a dodge roll. I mean you can think more like Star Fox, I guess. It's not like not quite because you like actually fly around and you have to like put complete objectives by like going and get like killing bad guys.
Alright, I lost myself.
Yeah, I'm disoriented.
I don't know how to fix that.
You want me to do it?
Fine.
Let's shoot.
Square, I believe.
Square.
Well, all square right. For the machine gun, triangle for the rockets.
Alright. Okay, it's like flight controls. I gotta get used to that again.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Up is down, down is Larry. Right is wrong, and wrong is right.
Right is wrong, wrong is right, mate. It's pretty cool how the aiming thing just leads it. And
yeah.
I know that's, like, nothing new for games like this. But it's new to me.
So, yeah, it's a nice thing to have.
It's like, aim at the green thing, and that'll, like, lead right.
I feel like red is bad, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, red is definitely bad.
Yeah.
Oh, you can see your the bad guy's reticles. That's actually really cool.
No, that's not his reticle. That's where you have to shoot.
That's where you have to shoot.
That's your lead indicator.
No, I mean like the yellow thing, though.
Yellow thing?
Yellow?
He has a little yellow circle floating around?
Yeah, that's the lead indicator.
That's for you. That shows you where you have to shoot to like, hit him if he keeps him in the same direction.
Oh, I see. That's cool.
Yeah, it, like...
That's actually really cool. Not a lot of flight games do that.
Yeah.
Not a lot of flight games do that shit. That's really cool. Do I have a boost?
Uh-huh.
Okay, I don't know if I...
Also, like, I do believe you fired them off.
Nice.
I like how the machine gun takes a second to start spinning.
Yeah.
It's kinda cool. It like feels like it's more powerful than machine guns in other games. Like, usually the machine gun, I never use it in like games like this. And it sucks, like in every other game. This seems to be like my best option.
Yeah. Stay glued to that radar. This island is still crawling with bogeys. Ah, oh, bogeys! I'm gonna make
you eat those words. Rookie! You got more enemy readings in your area, and they're heading for those Sea Sergeant helicopters.
Get out there and intercept them. I'm on it. How do I do like those cluster missiles? Oh, there we go. That's how I do the boosts.
How's that?
X. I just didn't hold them down long enough.
Okay. So it has a little startup time?
Yeah.
Cool. Wow. Look at everyone after that guy.
Yeah.
Try out a missile on that dude. Okay. They have like cluster shots and it's pissing me off. I want to do that too also.
I thought that's what your missile was.
It seemed like I don't see it like breaking off and doing a cluster.
Maybe not.
So I don't know what it's doing. So it's going behind.
Did you try circle?
I did not really try circle. There it is. Okay. That's what I want. I want that. That's the thing I want to do. I want to do dodge rolls and shoot cluster missiles. That's what I want to do in every plane game. Don't make a plane game unless you have that.
I don't want yo rules. I just want a dodge roll and cluster missile. All the
time. Because if I'm not mistaken, there's going to be a part in this game where I can go between plane and robot like on the fly.
Oh, man.
And that's the best...
Yeah, there's another game that's a lot like this that I got, shit, what was it? I'm looking it up, but it's, you go between, like, robot fighting form and, like, plane form all the time, and you're shooting down, like, stuff in space.
I'm gonna laugh if it's just another Macross game.
It might be in this, like, canon of it all, but... Like, it's not called Macross for sure.
You gotta shoot the other thingy. Yeah, you gotta shoot the... Yeah.
Yeah. You wanna be aiming for the green thing at all times.
Yeah. You guys head back to the because then it won't show us mercy.
SDF-1
control to Wolf Squadron. I like your hair buns. As soon as you
are refueled and rearmed, proceed to Macross City to defend assigned
sectors. Whee! Woo! Let's party!
Yeah.
It's a skip back to coming at you.
Oh yeah, baby.
Ooh yeah, baby.
The strafing and boosting.
Don't get me fired by strafing and boosting. I love that.
Son of a bitch.
On the beach.
Son of bitch. You're walking down street like bitch.
Oh, yeah. You got like a weird like halfway form.
How do I walk? Oh, yeah, forward. Okay, and I have a halfway form. I don't know how I'm controlling this.
I don't know how you're controlling it either.
Kind of got, like, floaty tank controls.
Oh, there you go. Oh, that's how I did that. That's really cool, because D-pad just does... Oh, sweet. Okay, nice. So D-pad is, like, plane. Half plane. Man.
Full plane.
That's it. I'm going into full demon form.
Yeah, full demon form.
I am now Yami Dark Yasha.
Yeah. Doesn't Yami mean dark?
Yes.
Yeah.
I am dark, dark Yasha.
I am dark, dark Yasha. How? It's the same way as like a dark, dark knight is darker than a like a dark knight.
Yes. I'd say that's very accurate. I'm ruining people's cars. Okay, I can't do that. That's a bummer.
Yeah, it is a bummer.
Well, I want to be a plane now, so it's plane time.
It's plane time.
Alright.
This would be a really cool, like, multiplayer game. Just
It might have multiplayer. I don't remember.
Well, not, like, online or anything. But
Online it would have been great. Oh, I can only do a plane for a little bit. Or no, I can't.
No, it's just that you can't go that far up.
Okay, I don't know what the middle form is supposed to do.
It gives you, like, hover abilities, I think.
Yeah, but I can't move very good in it. Oh, I have to hit up on the D-pad to move, but that's also transformation. That's not the greatest, but I guess I can get used to that. Like, you have to get the momentum started. You can't,
The game I was thinking of is called Strike Suit Zero.
Yeah.
And, yeah, super cool. It's a lot like this, only in space.
Oh, no, shit!
Turn my sniper rifle off, please. Okay, I need to go fast. Yeah, I really didn't, though. How do I do my cluster missiles? Do I not get them when I'm robot time? Oh, that's why I do halfway form, so I can, like, not fly my ass off the screen, and then use my cluster missiles.
Aha!
I have better weapons in that form, I see. Okay.
I do like how, Japan thinks this is the future.
Yeah.
I mean, it could be still. I mean, we are building giant robots to fight Japan with right now.
Yeah.
And we do have a crazy person running the world, so, I mean...
Yeah.
It could just happen for no reason.
Have you seen the Clickhole article? It's saying, like, fuck, what was it that they did? It was like, Japan just releases new whatever, which proves that they're still sophisticated enough to destroy the world if they wanted to.
Yeah. I'm having some difficulties dodging.
I think it was about the Switch.
Yeah, the Nintendo's...
Breath of the Wild,
That's
Breath
great.
Of the Wild is so good, it proves that their technology is good enough to probably destroy the world if they wanted to.
I keep reading there's like a startup on the gun. This is fucking me over. Oh, I just blow up.
What were you reading?
What? I forgot there was a startup on the gun, like you had to hold it down
before
it actually shoots.
Dude, he didn't head to zone 209. That was your problem.
Yeah, I didn't head to zone 209.
Yeah, all he really had to do was head to zone 209.
I don't know where that even is.
I don't know what the big deal is.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah, they told you zone 209 is you go there every day and get some hot dogs.
You go to zone 209 and you hold it. That's what I do. SDF-1 control to Wolf 10
and alien. Can I skip cutscenes?
Yeah.
Okay. I have to use I have to press forward on the D-pad and then aim with the left stick.
What
I'm
the
not
fuck?
Even kidding you. I'm doing that right now. That was not a good call.
Yeah.
They should have just made it the other stick. I don't know why they didn't. I can't aim with the other
one
at all.
Came out.
I remember it being on like a really old like X-Play like before like it was like a comedy thing.
The big question is, was it before 2001?
Probably.
When dual stick became kind of the thing.
I think it was after that.
Yeah, there were still a lot of people who were just like, well, you know, we're still trying to create the standard. And we don't want to accept the fact that Halo started it.
Yeah, pretty much. Going back to GoldenEye controls is really hard.
Yep.
Like back then, it made so much sense to me. And I don't know how I even did. I don't know how I did it.
Yeah. It's time. Time takes us all, man.
Yeah.
Time. We're all gonna just rot and die one day.
I really love how like controversial it is when people say, like, oh, GoldenEye, like, held up. It's like...
Not really.
Yeah, it really didn't, though. it controlled by, like, a butt by today's standards.
Yeah, it really did.
I mean, it controls so that you can still have fun playing it.
Yeah.
I mean, you get. I mean, like, isn't there a version of the game that uses like updated controls?
Oh yeah,
GoldenEye Source, right?
Yeah, like it's like.
Totally I mean, they released like an actual version as well.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, they like did a re-release of GoldenEye. With like real.
Man, I don't know how anybody in this town is even alive. With robots just running around corners like this.
I don't know.
Do you think there are a bunch of celery men up in those windows right now? Look out and go, oh, again.
Okay. Yeah. Every day with this.
Oh, yep, the robots are shooting again. I guess I'm not taking lunch yet.
Yeah.
Yes. I hope that robot that turns into planes shows up and it just shoots through a sandwich. Ah, fuck!
Again.
Oh, that's a really easy, really quick way to break, I guess. Let's just go straight into that form. Oh, that's cool. I like how you can, like, slide across the ground.
Yeah.
That's neat.
Like super animated. It's great.
Yeah.
That's fun.
It's and you put your hand out to, like, stop yourself.
I guess no. Oh, for God's sakes, just fucking go home.
Stop shooting me. All right. Oh,
fuck.
This city is disrespectful to U.S. Marines.
Yeah!
It's been reported to YouTube.
To YouTube.
Fuck you, bitch. I will fucking kill you in real life. This server is disrespectful to Marines and has been reported to YouTube. Bitch.
I love that. It's,
I like they're reporting it to the one thing that has the least authority on anything, even itself.
Yeah.
Aha! Okay, bye!
No!
Okay, bye!
What?
I'm just blowing up my own town. Don't worry about me. Oh, jeez. Oh, boy. Oh, I'm gonna hear about this.
Alright. Mission success.
Nope. No. Oh, there we go. That's what I... Okay, that makes going forward much easier.
Are you boosting that form?
Oh, thank God I can boost in this form.
So instead of, like, crawling forward slowly, you just kind of
because, like, you had to hit up on the D-pad to do that, and it really sucks a lot.
So training was a good idea.
Yeah, probably.
Hypothetically.
It would have been.
I'm learning how to do it, though. It's...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my God!
Oh my God!
Bye! Please! Leave! Please!
Does that mean you're a biplane?
Yes! I like both planes with four wings and two wings. Jack
the Giant Killer. Oh, okay. Okay. I'll Jack the Giant Killer.
Yo.
No, that was a command to you right now.
Yeah.
Right now, right now, right now.
Right now. I need to turn into a plane right now, right now, right now, right now.
It doesn't matter if I'm 25 or 20.
It's a lemurosis.
It doesn't matter if you do untold collateral damage to the city. I just need it on my dick right now, right now.
Yeah.
Right now.
Time to take these men to Flavortown.
But yeah, the Switch has a bittering agent on it.
That's hilarious. Which,
meaning, if you, like, play a lot of Switch games and then, like, act like lick your hands for whatever reason...
You just got junk on your hands. It tastes gross.
You'll taste it for a while.
Because I remember, like, somebody from Vine Sauce saying they tasted
one. Don't try it. Kids at home, please don't try it.
Like for real, they really shouldn't, but I know they're going to, because they know.
I know, exactly. Like, don't try it. Right, Taha? Don't.
It's like Nintendo basically told people to lick their cartridges by saying it would taste bad, because people are going to like wonder, like, how bad does it taste?
They're going to be like, really? does it taste bad?
It's okay. Like people have this weird fucked up thing where, like, just some weird, like curious pleasure you get from, like, knowing how bad something is.
Yeah.
So, like, somebody tells you, don't eat that, it tastes bad.
That's what our channel is.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
It's like, oh, that's probably really bad. Let's see what that's like.
Wow, I'm glad I'm not involved in that. It's like the same reason I really enjoy the footage of that, like, cobra about to bite that guy, and then he just slaps it and it just goes down.
Yeah.
It's like, I really hope to never be in that situation, but goddamn, he just slaps it and it just stops.
It's like, oh, okay. Well.
I like when they put the Metal Gear Solid, like, snake dying sounds to it.
Yeah.
It just goes, oh, oh! It, like, does the whole thing. It's great. Because it's just this big ass snake getting slapped by some guy.
Kind of like how Otacon, they have the same speech with like Otacon. And Otacon's like, alright, yeah, cool. Well, let's kill Metal Gears forever now.
Yes, that's what we do. We kill Metal Gears forever. And then Ocelot has a moment where he like conducts a battle.
Yeah.
The
shaking is like,
oh, the guns was so great. The Yosemite Sam guns.
Yeah.
Oh!
God damn, that was
I figured out how this mode works.
How it work now?
You don't have to hold up on the D-pad. You just press, like, up and down on the D-pad to set your speed.
Oh.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Oh, I see. And you just auto just will hover that speed forever.
Yeah.
Okay, I was missing that. Yeah, watch out for the Destroids.
Yeah. Here I go. Giving them
plane
support.
Now. Hit that building.
Yeah.
It's closing the car. That building got bodied.
Oh no.
When Yipes was asked,
what happened to that building just now?
He says, "Wow, that building got bodied." The tragedy of what happened will never be forgotten. Yipes' biting commentary. Fun. Just imagining like this horrible like tragedy.
It was like, ooh.
Ooh! Get your ass whooped! So bad. I don't think this factory is savable. Like, looking at it,
yeah, like, it's like,
I think it's done, though.
Oh jeez, what the fuck?
Whoa! Didn't know you had roller skates.
Yeah, hey, dude.
You guys can help if you want to. Okay, cool.
Thanks, guys.
at least they're helping a little. They're not like dying immediately. Like at least they're not like ads that just melt.
Yeah.
I hate that. Like when they give you extra guys and they don't actually contribute to the damage or even like.
Yeah, all they are is a count of how many you've lost.
Yep, they're just a liability. That's kind of what they become in, like, Zone of the Enders, but...
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, let them come to you.
As far as the God-tier strats go, I think I may have found it.
Yeah, I think you figure it out.
You just fucking strafe into sight. Shoot a packet of missiles.
Yeah, that's how I play Metal Wolf Chaos.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I felt like this form that you are right now is probably one of the better ones. I just couldn't figure out how the fuck it works. Because, like, I didn't know, like, if I had to hold that button down or not. But I guess you can move forward if you just, like, tap it and then just... Then you can move around and just make sure you're...
Shit. Watching your screen. All right, sweet.
Nice.
Yeah, I deliberately skipped the training, too.
Yeah.
They probably would have explained all of that.
It's fine.
Yeah. Woo! Got promoted to sergeant! Wow.
You're a seer, Jance.
Whoa, look at how many shots... Wait for the stat to come back. Yeah!
Oh, yeah!
Oh. I feel like I'm going to be left behind. Eternal forces.
Don't get left behind and then get replaced with robots.
Yeah, yeah. Goddamn.
666 shots fired.
7, 7, 7, 7, 6. If you're 5, 5, 5, then I'm 666.
And that slowly, like... kills you as you hear it.
God.
Like, you imagine that song just, like, actually killing you.
The SDF-1 was able to escape the Zentradi attacks by executing a spacefold maneuver,
which took
most of
the
island along with it. I nearly got killed when that happened, and was in the hospital for months before I could fly again. After recovering from my injuries, they stationed me at Alaska base. All my friends from the academy were on board the SDF-1.
Go to Alaska. Go to Alaska.
The SDF-1 didn't get a very warm reception when they returned. The United Earth government flatly refused to help them. They had survived for a year out in space under constant attack by the Zentradi,
only
to be told that they weren't wanted back on Earth.
And why
Chiron,
do you
who was maybe the worst of the Zentradi warriors, continued to launch attacks on the SDF-1 after it returned home. When I heard that Roy Fulkerson had been killed,
what are the odds?
I visited the SDF-1 to attend his funeral. That's when Chiron chose to attack. Captain Global decided to test out a new barrier system they had developed. Which
you
won't.
Oh,
Steve!
It's kind of like Zoe. There's gonna be you gotta fight the big floating enemy that has a barrier. So like you gotta either wait for him to do his attack or he drops it.
Yeah.
Or you gotta kill a bunch of ads while he's attacking you.
Yeah.
That will drop the barrier, then get a short time to fight him. I'm pretty sure it's one of those two things. It's almost always is.
Goddamn.
The barrier is to protect the thing that you're protecting.
Oh,
you're the ads.
Oh, okay. I thought that was a bad thing. I wasn't even paying attention.
Okay.
Like, it's Italian hands.
Like the, yeah.
Italian robot.
The Lego.
Good to see you again, Jack. I wish it were under better circumstances.
You just worry about those fighters. I'll try to keep you out of trouble.
Time to take these guys to school. Open up the books and get started on a lesson.
Well, oh, you can't. Oh, you can't do a loop de loop.
Yeah, I don't. Maybe you can. I don't know if I don't know how to do it.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to do.
Yeah, I don't know
like
if you
when
can
I
do
first
that.
Started, it was all like, no, don't play this.
If you can't do those, I don't know if there's like I feel like there's probably a lot of maneuvers you don't know about like in the plane form. Like maybe you can do loop de loops and like because you can do one of those.
Oh I see. Okay, I got confused.
Yeah.
Because I thought that my enemy was on the other side of that, but he was not.
No, it's just on the front of that ship. You want to shoot the red stuff.
So, like, that shield, how do we check the health of that?
I don't know.
Beats me.
Maybe there isn't one, you just gotta fight the things and then win.
Somewhere around here, there is the guy that I was locked onto. I'm just gonna fucking, like...
I figured that was like a quasi-time limit kind of thing.
But yeah, like games like this, like these flight, like, combat games, like, really Rogue Squadron really, like, made these, like, good...
Yeah.
And, like, that game still holds up because a lot of the rules from that are still used in these games.
Yeah.
And, like...
That was a Star Wars game, right?
Yeah, Star Wars, like, you could, like, do the whole thing with the AT-AT walkers where you, like, throw the big cable onto their legs and then spin around them and like clip their legs together and they fall over.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Do that like in game.
Where the fuck did he go? God damn it! There he is. Fuck. Fuck, it always fucking like.
Yeah.
Takes forever to stop goat looking up or down.
Yep.
If I were Armake 21 back in the day.
Broken fucking controls!
Yeah.
God damn, it's so fucking like. Like, that is like painful. Like, and, like, somebody like just was just shouting that without like any sort of like character or like joke. Just yelling mad.
There's the problem with this game. Broken fucking controls.
It's like, that's an easy thing to say. I mean, like, you could, like, tell me why they're broken. Like, what do? Like, why don't they work? Like...
Okay, these fucking, like, little turrets have gotta fucking go.
Yeah, you're gonna die if they, like, laser in you in the butt while you're trying to fight the little dudes.
I think those things being dead, I said dead, is real good for you.
They're lasers.
Well, Walt's a scientist, and scientists like lasers.
If scientists like lasers!
Laser tag!
He wasn't wrong, that was a good choice, he was just being stupid.
I don't know what that is.
Like I feel like this
little
game,
tiny rocket.
I feel like this game would be like a really great game for like fans of Macross, because like it's got all this stuff from Macross in it.
Yeah.
That's like I feel like if I was into Macross, I would be like, oh dude, they got the thing. They're in this. Like every 5 seconds.
Yeah. No! Don't overload the omnidirectional barrier system! That's one of our best systems!
It's like the omnidirectional barrier system is what they call their fucking, like braces. Or some shit.
My retainer.
Yeah, like your retainer.
Yeah. It's my cross retainer.
Did you figure out what conducts a barrel roll doing one?
If you boost, you can just do it.
Oh, sweet. Okay, so if you're boosting, then you can, and then you hit the
trigger. If I, like, hit that and start boosting, I just start spinning. Otherwise, it seems to be just, like, I don't know, sometimes when you're turning, it'll roll you. If you press the button to lean the opposite direction, it likes to roll you sometimes, I guess.
Okay. It's probably a little bit inconsistent. I didn't really sure what was causing it. Because, like, Star Fox is, like, you just hit the button, it'll just, like, tilt you, but if you like hit it really fast, like then you'll spin, or Star Wars 64, then you would spin right away, then you would just be tilting. But I know like later ones, like if you click the button in or you like tap it really fast, then you'll do the barrel rolls.
Attention, all Veritech fighters! Emergency! Evacuate the area immediately. The barrier system is about to chain react. Got to get away from here, quick! Mission failed.
Alrighty then.
Mission failed.
And it just says mission failed, big ass text.
Yeah.
Mission failed. So, well, that was hard and difficult to control. It was kind of neat, though.
Yeah.
It was kind of neat anyways. Rip.
Rip.